When you look at the semi group overall in the last month and a half, I mean, they are down 25 to 35% from their peaks in October. And a lot of that had to do with the trade tariff war that is going on. Because if you look at the actual impact, and we did a sensitivity analysis of all these stocks, they're impacted 6 to 10% on the EPS line, earnings line, as you look at next year. So the downdraft that you saw in semis, a lot of that was with the uncertainty that the tariff war brought along. And what we have been hearing is even OEMs, suppliers in China have been cutting back on inventories, thinning down their channels because there's uncertainty on how much of the cost, the 25% cost hike, can be passed on to their customers. So they have been cutting back on their own inventories. They don't know what the demand visibility is. So a lot of that has to do with the tariffs. So we think if there's some resolution, is a delay like what we saw yesterday, you should see the stocks react, and that's what we saw yesterday. And I think there's a pretty distinct possibility that we get some sort of a half a resolution on this that should be positive for these names.
So even though it's just a reprieve right now and there's a 90-day process and all that, you think the market is going to give them credit for having dodged this bullet?
Yeah, I think if you look at the commentary post-earnings from a lot of the semi-manufacturers, it has about very little visibility into the March quarter. Now with the push-out, you should start to see the March quarter orders start to show up on the books because before you didn't have any visibility. And you might even have a pull-in from June quarter to March quarter as people try to get ahead of that 25% hike deadline end of March. But again, if we get to some sort of a resolution before that, I think it'd be very positive for the group. So.
Bob? Assuming we don't have a resolution anytime soon, tell us a little more about inventories and supply line disruptions. People trying to go this way when they're not sure if they should go that way. That can't be great news, right?
Yeah, I think there's a couple of things happening. One is with this whole tariff thing, you have inventories being cut back very significantly. So the inventories in the channel are very lean, especially in China, because OEMs don't want to sit on inventories. They don't know how much they can sell. And so that's what part of what you're seeing in terms of the cutback on the semi companies on their guides. The second thing that you're seeing happening is many of these OEMs in China are moving supply chains around. They're taking supply chains out of China back to Taiwan or the Philippines or Vietnam. And so that's causing a little bit of a disruption also. But that's more mid to longer term. And I think that will continue to be the case. You will see supply chains in PC servers and even in some cases equipment move out of China back into some of the other geographies. But near term, that's a disruption. But I think the biggest impact definitely is the tariff headlines. So.